Get ready to match the stars from MASH, Gary Burghoff, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Hope Lange, Richard Dawson, and Patti Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you very much. That's my microphone. Is this your mommy? No? Is this your mommy? No.
By the way, these are the two new owners of CBS.
Is this your daddy?
Am I your daddy?
Thanks.
Is this your daddy?
Yeah. I fooled him again.
Is this your mommy?
Yeah.
No. Yes?
You don't belong to me.
Is this your mommy?
Mm-hmm. Hello.
That's your mommy.
That's young Max.
Max Ross. Patty's beautiful child. Now.
Come pick your nose on television.
Is this your daddy?
Ah, yeah.
That's not your daddy. Is this your mommy? No.
No? Is that your grandmommy?
Is this your daddy?
That's your daddy. That's Gina Burghoff, a beautiful child.
Well, let him hang around for a little while and give at least, I mean, it'll be safe until the first commercial, I assure you.
You don't have to ask a question. He's writing the answer already.
Terrific. Terrific.
Max, how scare you?
He's a good speller and he's a clever kid. Let's say hello to Diana Lebowski and Jane Kelly. Hi, Diana, here is the current champion. She's won 2 games. She has $450 to her credit. How do you feel about that?
Great.
Good. And she's being challenged by this gerontologist.
That's right.
Jane Kelly. Would you believe she's only 18 years old? But she's so expert in her field, in the study of the prevention of aging, that she appears to be...
Jane.
I won't say
Jane.
It.
Jane. Jane, is that your daddy?
All right, we're going to start this game in a moment or so, right after we do a little business with America. We're ready. Round one. Jane, you may have A or B.
A, please.
You want A?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
By the way, we would like to thank Central Casting for sending the two dwarfs over to help us out. We were slipping in ratings a little, and we thought we'd touched the heart. Next week, we're going to have dogs.
Right. Betty White's going to bring 4 animals.
Right.
One of them will... No. Harold said, I've got the toughest job in Hollywood. I'm the hairdresser for blank.
Yeah.
Who said that, dear?
Harold said, I got the toughest job in Hollywood. I'm the hairdresser for blank.
Oh, cute.
Toughest job in Hollywood.
Oh.
Oh, you got to show the answer.
Oh,
that...
I will.
Oh, you will. All right.
Thank
you. Good. Wonderful. Yeah, let's put that right there in the slot. There you go. She's finished. Wait for Chuck. And Patty will be finished in a second. Jane, you've been thinking about this now.
Mm-hmm.
Don't say it yet. I'll tell you when to say it. Okay. Patty, ready?
Yes.
She's writing an answer
now. She's nervous because she's a stage mother and her kid was just here and she's just a wreck.
Yes. Harold said, I've got the toughest job in Hollywood. I'm the hairdresser for blank.
Telly Savalas.
Telly Savalas. That would be an easy job? That would be an easy job, they say.
It's not
what do you
being nervous, it's being asleep all the time. I said Lassie.
Lassie! That would be difficult because there's a lot of hair to comb there, isn't there? What did you say?
I don't want to start a lot of ugly fights. You know, there's been enough dissension on the show.
Right.
So just don't.
Yeah.
But take a look. Sienna.
Charles. yeah. Hello, Charles.
Is that your daddy?
10 years I try to get out. Oh, off a kid shows it's the illness I have. King Kong and it stinks and I know it.
No, King Kong is not bad because he's got a lot of hair all over his
that's
body.
And
that's
my
an
hair is
answer.
My own.
No, no, Charles, King Kong is a wonderful answer. All right, Hope. I've got the toughest job in Hollywood. I'm the hairdresser for...
Next to Charles.
Lassie is good because that's a hairy animal. Richard?
I am Charles, a hairdresser. And it is not a tough job at all.
It's easy.
Nothing
how do you
to
do it?
Just throw it in the washer.
Oh, yes.
King Kong.
King Kong it is. You got any idea now, right, Jane?
That's right.
Okay, Patti Deutsch.
Max helped me with this answer.
He did?
Yes. So get a close-up of it. It says Lassie.
Oh, yeah. Oh, and he drew Lassie. Yeah. That yes. Very good. That was...
Before his flea bath.
Quite...
Before he even knew the question.
Yes,
amazing that the child knew in advance what the question would be.
My child wrote out my card.
Oh, really? Here we go.
Oh.
Did you upside down?
Yeah. You noticed that, didn't you? That the card was upside down. All right, just for that.
So are your contact lenses.
Lucy said...
Goodbye to that funny.
No, wait, now I'm going to see if I can read this upside down. Lucy said, we just finished doing a new Charlie Brown special.
Yeah.
In this one, I don't go anywhere near Charlie. Leave me alone.
Okay.
He starred on Broadway in Charlie Brown. I don't go anywhere near Charlie. It's called You've Got Blank, Charlie Brown. Lucy said we just finished doing a new Charlie Brown special, and this one I don't go anywhere near Charlie. It's called You've Got Blank, Charlie Brown.
Oh, I get it.
All right.
Ready for you.
Brown Charlie.
Very good.
Blank.
Very good.
Got your.
You're okay.
Thank you.
Right.
Charlie.
Yeah. Near. Narnia, Brown.
Are you my daddy?
No, I'm not your daddy.
What a.
Lucy said, we just finished doing a new Charlie Brown special. And this one, I don't go anywhere near Charlie. It's called You've Got Blank, Charlie Brown.
B.O.
B.O.
Older.
All right. Yes, sirree.
That means body odor.
Yeah. Right.
Mm-hmm. I said bad breath.
Bad breath? No. But those are the two good choices, B.O. and B.B. What do you say?
You are my daddy.
No, I'm not.
That's what you told me in Encino. You said, little girl, you're going
to
hurt
our
daddy.
Cool. Dear Kinder is schlafen backstage.
What the
hell
does that mean?
B.O. Okay, one for Diana. Yep.
Bad breath, sometimes.
All right. Well, no, that was one of the two good possibilities. B.B. or B.O. So at this moment, scores 1-0. Favor Diana. Hope, it's called You've Got Blank, Charlie Brown.
Well, I went for bad breath, too.
All right. And you, sir, what did you go for? Oh, yeah. That garlic will get you every time. You.
Psoriasis.
Oh.
No heartbreak.
Yep. Too bad. Terrible. So there we are at the end of round one. Scores 1-0. Favor the champ. Round two coming up after this. Do come back. Thanks, all. Here we are. Round two coming up. This is the final round, Jane. You may have A or B.
I'll try B this time.
B is what she wants.
All right.
Everyone will play this round because she didn't match anyone in the first round. Muggsy said, oh, boy. When I was a kid, we were so poor. Every day my father used to go blanking in an open manhole. That's how poor we was when I was a kid. Every day my father used to go blanking in an open manhole. You understand, lady? I mean, I was poor. Yeah. I know you was never poor, but try and understand how it is to be poor.
How do you spell that?
Every day I used to go blanking in an open manhole. That's how poor we was when I was a kid. You know how it was when you were in Hartford, Connecticut. You were very poor, too.
May I ask a question? Does that question make sense?
Like you said, when I was a kid, we were so poor, every father... Oh, I got it! Oh, it took a minute. Yeah. Oh, you know, I have to read stuff because I'm
it.
A reader, don't you know?
Finally got it.
And here she goes.
All right, Jane. Here we go. Munchie said, when I was a kid, we were so poor. Every day, my father used to go blanking in an open manhole.
Searching.
Searching.
The quarters that dropped through the
grates. I see. I don't think it's going to make it for you.
Isn't it terrible? They don't leave you alone.
At home,
they hound you, these people.
You say searching and you...
These people paid to get in here. They would come in here to go, oh!
Yeah. That gives them a certain pleasure.
Actually, if I paid to come in here, I also would go, oh.
But you see, it gets rid of their unresolved hostilities, and they don't go home and beat their wives. So it's good for them to come here.
The rest of us, of course, are very resolved.
Yes.
I said golfing.
Oh! We're hitting a new low now.
Yeah, not in front of the kid, folks. Give him a break.
Trust me, you kids are going to love this answer. I do not lie to you. You mind your own beeswax. Fishing!
Oh, sure. But Johnny Holson had to tell him to do that.
That's the definitive answer, I would say, or one of them.
No, it's not definitive.
What is?
Because you can go fishing in the ocean just as cheaply as you can go fishing in a manhole.
Yeah, but if you live in Chicago or Indianapolis, it's very difficult to go to the ocean.
Mommy. I said shopping. Maybe that's the match.
Shopping. Shopping and searching are two different things, of course. Isn't this a jolly bunch, Hope?
It is. I like this hospital very much.
Yes. Aren't you glad you showed up today? Yeah. The food was
right
good and all
therapy
that?
Right after.
Right. All right, every day my father used to go blanking in an open manhole. How do you respond to that?
Since Brent and I share the same hospital room, I said, fishing.
That's okay, Richard, here we go.
Similario.
Fishing. Jane, you must match Patti to stay in the game and achieve a tie. What have you got there, Patti?
Fishing.
That means... Okay. Pleasure to meet you, Jane.
Thank you.
We're going to send some gifts your way, and we thank you for being here with us on Match Game 78.
Well timed.
Good. Jane Kelly, ladies and gentlemen. A nifty lady. There's the girl. All right. Would you believe this is our third time, and all she has is $350?
$500.
Oh, $550. Yeah.
Doesn't she still doesn't she still have Jeff, though? That's the important thing.
Yes. Now, wait a minute. I don't know if she has Jeff or not.
Maybe he's not
Jeff,
here.
Are you still with her?
Yeah.
You still with her?
Yes, sir.
Are you still supporting her?
Yes, I am.
Who are you rooting for?
Diana.
Let's hear it for Diana. Yay. Okay. That's her husband. Did he just finish medical school, or is he a full-fledged doctor?
He's a full-fledged doctor.
Oh, he is. Oh, in December he did that. Well, congratulations to him. That's terrific. Okay. And before we go to the audience match here, Diana, we'll do a little business in America, and then you hurry right back and see how much money she wins, okay? Hey, Johnny Olson, we shall continue here with Diana Lebowski. She now has $550, and we'll try for $5,000 or more. We wish her the best of luck, and we'll begin. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, Diana. We said you write down your best answer to this. Soft as blank. Remember how it goes? You get $500 for matching the most frequently given answer, $250 for the second most popular answer, and then $100 for the third. Three of the six loonies will help you.
Charles.
Soft as...
silk.
Silk.
Hope.
Hope.
Soft as rain.
Soft as rain. All right.
Okay, Patty.
A baby's tushy. Yeah!
Soft as a baby's bottom, she said, or tushy, or however you want to say it. Soft as rain and soft as silk are the three. Remember the option now. Choose one of those or give us one of your own.
Silk.
Soft as silk is the one that Charles gave us. All right. Let's see if we have a little silk up there. I'm sure somebody must have thought of a baby's. Oh, because that really is soft. But silk is soft, too, but not as soft as a baby's. Well, all right. We'll find out. May we see the $100 number, if you please? Soft as a kitten. That's soft, isn't it? Right. All right, let's go up the line and look at the next one, if you please. $250. A baby's bottom is there. That was Patty's answer. All right, you know, you may be right with the silk there. Let's find out right now. May we see the $500 number? Yeah! Well, Diana, you made a giant leap forward with that because you picked up another $500 and you're over $1,000 now. And you're going to play for $5,000. And you will collect the money if you match one celebrity exactly.
Richard.
Okay, Richard, here we go. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Good luck to you.
Thank you.
Worth $5,000. And it says, grocery blank. Okay, Diana, he's made up his mind. You give us the answer that he's written on the card, and we'll give you the $5,000. Grocery?
Store.
Store. Okay. She says grocery store will match you for the $5,000. Richard, what do you say?
I wrote two, and I chose the wrong one. I said less.
You got store there? Oh, gosh. Gee, that was close.
The one I thought of first.
Yeah. That's okay. We ask you to write the first thing that comes into your mind, and that's what came into his mind, and grocery store came into her mind first. Well, listen, you've improved your position considerably. You've got $1,050, and you're going to meet Wendy Thornton right now, and here we go. Wendy, you know Diana?
Yes, I do.
We welcome Wendy Thornton, and we'd like to find out a little bit about you.
I'm from Vancouver, Canada, and I was working in an office there for several years, but I've taken time off now to concentrate on traveling and writing.
Really? And have you had anything published yet?
No, just starting.
You write short stories? What is your form?
Mostly songs.
Oh, songs. Lyrics and music? And...
Yes.
Well, that's a marvelous avocation. We wish you well in that.
Thank you.
And good luck here, too, Wendy. Are you ready to play? You may have A or B.
I'll take A, please.
All right. Wendy Thornton wants A. Here's what it says. Norm said, I'm in favor of saving energy, but this is ridiculous. Who ever heard of a blank-powered radio? I'm in favor of saving energy, but this is ridiculous, because who ever heard of a blank-powered radio? Yes, wonderful. Well, you know what we're after here. Alternative means of energy, right? Okay. Any old way.
Wait a week. Okay.
You want to see my kid again?
What's that?
Just thought you could come out and fill in, you know.
Norm says... I'm in favor of saving energy, but this is ridiculous. Who ever heard of a blank-powered radio?
Pedal-powered?
Pedal-powered is one way of powering radio and running an electric generator, and that would be ridiculous because you'd have to stay on your bicycle all the time and do that, right?
That's true, but that's actually a good answer, but I said wind.
Wind is another way of generating electricity, and I would hope they would do more of that.
I said save gas, as in wind.
Gas-powered, yes. They'd do that. Gas, of course, would generate steam, and the steam would drive the turbine. The turbine would drive the generator. Hello, Charles.
You and her are driving me bananas.
I would hope so.
Don't move. That's our job.
Windmill.
Windmill. That's the way to do it. Okay, whoever heard of a blank-powered radio, and she said pedal-powered.
Whoever heard of this dumb answer? I said batteryless, and I couldn't spell it at all.
Batteryless powered radio.
Right.
Well, that's what we were after, something like that.
A cigar.
Blowing in the wind.
Wind power. That's, you know, a windmill. Now, here we, now this is going to be a nifty answer, Wendy. Watch this. Because
well, the operative word was whoever heard of.
Whoever heard of, yeah, of course.
A hamster with wheel.
A hamster with wheel. Runs around that thing and keeps it going around. You attach a little generator to it. Oh, wonderful. Okay. See how it goes? Now we've got this for America, and then we'll see what happens after that. Here we go. And goodbye. Thank you all for joining us here in Match Game 78.
GSM.